And good evening, Randomania, and welcome back to the Legend of Zelda Randomizer All Boards and All Swords Tournament. I am Dark Falls. With me today will be Fury SK, and Tracking Force behind the scenes will be Belmore at 79. Fury, how are you doing, my friend?
Doing well. Looking forward to seeing who wins game one of this race.
Yeah, you are a little invested in this one, are you not?
Yeah, just a little bit.
So this is a game one best of three between Antlers 44 and Truman Gamer. The winner of this will go on to face my co-com today. This is a Elite 8 flag set, so it should be quite interesting.
Yep, and you can already see what the heart start point is. It could have rolled 1-5, and they're going to be starting a little shorthanded, so it'll be a little bit more combat intensive on the overworld. Can't take as many hits.
Yeah, and we've seen that time and time again in this tournament, how overworld deaths can be on a little bit of a painful side. But we still have that armor slam that we got to find. We might not have a free candle. It depends on what the armor item is. Probably still want to buy a candle at some point, though, just to not waste time in routing. Alright, so we are going to be underway momentarily. When you play these flag sets, Fury, there's quite a bit of changes in them. What's your general thought process when you first begin a seed?
First thought is always to do a little bit of resource collection. If you don't have the resources built up early, it can impact you later on in the seed when you kind of run through them all and you don't have any bombs, don't have any keys, don't have any money. It's much more painful than it would be in bracket setup.
So it doesn't look like we're underway. We have a level right off the bat. Not going to take a look around, so we have no idea where that's going to be. So this is a mixed quest plus shapes dungeon setup. So 1 through 6 will be the same, 7 through 9 will be the same. It can be either first, second, or mixed in this case.
I have some ideas so far on this one, but it's probably too early to call.
Well, we have Dark Knights, whatever this is, and can't do those without bombs at the very, very least.
Yeah, so probably one of the most noteworthy things here is that there are 23 items as opposed to 15 items in the shuffle, so you might dig a dungeon early and come out with just a little bit more health, which with two hearts isn't bad, but normally is not what you want.
Truant has found one free heart in a take NES.
Mm-hmm.
So he does want to find that white sword in, which is still at play. Antler's finding another dungeon. White sword in is still between 4 and 6, so they do still have to find quite a few hearts to even have an attempt at that.
Yeah, looks like Antlers is in another dungeon, and this one leads me to believe that the front half of our dungeon setup is likely to be second quest.
Well, it could still be shapes, so we aren't sure quite yet. This does have the possibility to be either there 2 or 4, though.
Yeah, it could be, actually, now that we have a shutter door, all of a sudden things changed up just a little bit. If that one shutter door isn't there, you have a bit of a path. But it looks like it's also a column too far over, so we're changing it up.
Yeah, not quite sure what that one is. I'll have to come back to it.
So
So Antler's going to do our first armos check. Truant's going to tell us what's on the coast. On the coast is the wand. So that is a huge coast item to find.
Yeah, we have checked the armos in the Lost Hills, and it netted not the item, but looks like we're going to have to wait, because Lionel's is not really the setup you'd like on the Blue Ring Shop armos screen.
Antlers, let's have some bombs now. We're going to be able to take out some of these Octoroks and see if we can't get some more bombs. We don't, but he gets his heart.
Yeah, he's going to retry, I think, because he has that pack of bombs pretty much gone at this point, and you'd value just having information of where the heart is over not having any bombs and having to farm those again. Like I said, you're probably going to see a lot more of a retry after save strategy from these two runners than you saw in the Swiss rounds or the bracket rounds. It's pretty important just in case it's a second quest of any sort overworld. But now that he's got a heart container and six bombs, he may just opt to save again here shortly.
Yeah, he'll be down to bombs, but I'd rather keep the heart at this point. You have to spend a heart to get that anyway. Spend a bomb, I should say.
Yeah, well, he went from four bombs to essentially six bombs by getting the bomb drop, and then he got the heart container for his troubles. Unfortunately, he's losing a little bit of money. The good news is that it's only a 33% chance at this point of rolling a second quest overworld hit setup. The four options you have are full first quest overworld, first quest oriented mixed quest, second quest oriented mixed quest, and second quest outright.
Get some bombs off the blue Lionel, which is nice. Gonna save and keep those for later.
Yep, and what you're seeing from him is resets as well as saving. So he's basically refreshing his count to know where it is every time he decides to save his setup that he has going.
Truant picks up a fourth heart, and Antlers gets his free candle.
Yeah, with eight bombs and a candle, we'll see if he opts to maybe start looking at dungeons, or if he wants to continue looking until he finds at least the armos.
I would go for the armos first, always, because if it's not ladder, you can get that wand off the coast. And that wand will just pick up combat so much for him.
Well, if there's one large, it's going to end up being kind of a pedestrian large secret for this season.
Well, it's 93, so it's okay.
Yeah, it's good, but it's not above average. It's slightly below, so gotta hope that this is a three large secret overworld.
21 bombs, not awful. I won't buy too many, hopefully. Truant back into that gray dungeon, we'll see if he pokes around here a little bit, or if he keeps moving on. Antler's taking a Lino beam to the back. And while they are kind of walking around just a few little bit, we want to give a shout out to our tracker behind the scenes, Bill Mark 79, for doing a fantastic job as always. please give Belle some support. She's awesome and has helped us out a ton in this tournament.
Alright, 212 rupees and an arrow shop. I'm not surprised at all that he went ahead and just opted into that.
I would have checked the armos first, personally, because if that's silver, you just wasted $62.
You just up and retry, I guess.
Because if this is a, as you think, a second quest, 1 through 6, that's going to eat some keys. So you kind of want to have some money to buy keys if necessary.
My initial thought on the yellow one was that it was 3, but it's more likely to be 1 at this point if it's actually a non-shape. And I guess I should include in because second quest level 3 will not have 2 doors on its bottom segment. It will have 1 door and 1 wall that won't bomb.
We do have a bomb hole here. We go through it, and it's a potential staircase. If this is 2Q1, the item will, well, there'll be 2 items. Both will be on the ground.
Yep. And it's not going to be a slow mode red bubble, so I'm a little bit disappointed, personally.
Antlers does buy a key, and I can't tell if he's reverse controls or not. He's moving a little janky, so it's possible he's reverse controlled.
You can't. Hey, that's a nice try on a clip, but no dice. And you can't bomb right here. I'm ready to declare that that is Second Quest 1 at this point.
Yeah, I 100% agree with you. That's not 2Q1. So 1 through 6 at the very least will be Second Quest.
It's ladder blocked or combat blocked. We don't know necessarily if the item's in one of the rooms. And or the Triforce.
We do have a 39 medium secret, so that's actually really nice to have in the most prevalent secret, way above average.
And we have level 9 sighted on Antler's side, and it's first or shapes on the back half, so that's good information to have. And it looks like it's the middle cave on the bottom coast, with the right cave being another dungeon that we don't know yet.
And we just saw our armor side, it was a heart container, so on no hearts, that's not awful, but you kind of want something better than that.
Yeah, it's not surprising on a, I guess he had only item knowledge of one item, so it was like a 9 in 22 chance of being a heart. Pretty high chance.
Now we're in the kind of circumstance where we have to start digging item levels with just a candle and bonds at this point, though.
Yeah, but Antlers is going to get his information that he's going to need a ladder no matter what in the sea. And ladder with the wand on the coast, to me, that's a sign that I have to look in dungeons that are not 9 first. Because the chances that all dungeons are going to have an accessible Triforce and or potential items that are needed to beat bosses is kind of low. Not a guarantee, but just kind of the way I would play it.
Junior Gamer opts to just buy his key, which at this point he's in the forest, not a bad play. And it was only 42 rupees, so not gonna hurt him too much.
Yeah, this candle is pretty important for where he's at. He may take 2 candles if he goes over to first quest level 1, but you know, the chances he's gonna get over there before kind of routing through some of this forest on the way back is not good.
Yeah, while you're here, you don't want to double back unless you absolutely positively have to. So, at least this opens up his routing for him. And there's a staircase for Antlers. We'll see what's down here. I think Truant saw this one earlier.
Oh man, Truant going for the gambling game and hitting the minus 41, so he's down to nothing as far as his wallet's concerned.
Yeah, I mean, sometimes you win, sometimes you don't. And Truant did not get much in that one. And we find some any roads by Antlers. Not going to check it out quite yet. Going to check and see what else is in the casino corner here. Lost Hills, whatever you want to call it.
Oh, we find that we are not dedicated first as... Well, he's found out for the first time, I think, but... We saw the lake at Vanilla second quest, or Vanilla level 2 first quest. Tongue-tied there.
And we also saw that our blue Lynels are only 3 HP, so with those being bomb droppers on the overworld, that's actually nice to know that they're not beefed up a little bit.
Yep, door repair being, looks like 18 rupees is not terrible as well, so if it happens to be second quest money, it's, I guess, not too awful. Seen the key price now at 63, so again, if you're resource starved, these are a lot of good numbers for you.
Truant gets his 6th heart, so now he is guaranteed the white sword item, whatever it may be. Most likely going to be a heart, but we'll find that out once we come across it somewhere in this overworld.
It'd be intriguing if it's something like the book. That's kind of what I'd root for here.
Well, the book wouldn't be awful at this point, because they'll give you the maps at the very least. Hints, it won't do anything for us anymore, because we have community hints on at this point.
So the, we have an above average... We basically have a max small and a near max medium secret as well, so it's 20, 39, and just under 100 for the large.
So I would definitely say this is a better money than average seed at this point. Not great, but could be much worse. So we have another debt level up in this upper portion of the map. Not going to check it out yet, though. Curious why he is not. Could be getting more bombs? No, still moving on.
My guess would be he's kind of still in the mode of I need to collect enough resources in terms of money so that I have potential keys or I can find the white sword item in case that's something significant like the ladder. And even if it's not the ladder, it could be bow, could be silvers, as you mentioned earlier when he picked up the wood arrows. It could be red ring that saves you a little bit in health, so it's
could be the
at least
ladder
try.
Which gets in the wand as well.
It's important at least to try and find it with generic overworld routing. You may not want to dip Death Mountain super early, but everywhere else is pretty much game.
So we didn't mention our enemy HP. It's going to be plus or minus 4. So some of these enemies could be squishy. They could be much stronger than normal.
Looks like both runners are going to continue to opt out of early dungeon setup in this case.
We found 5 out of our 9 dungeons so far, so found quite a few of them. With this being quest 1, we will most likely need meat for level 3 as well. And Antlers did just get his armor item, so that might have been what he was looking for before he jumped into dungeons.
Well, we're going to get a good idea as to what this dungeon is pretty soon here. My guess, if I had one, would be second quest 6 based on that star point, but we're not really going to know until he actually gets a ladder to go up, I think.
He's able to kill one of the mold arms, gonna leave and come back in, the second one will be dead. no Triforce, so I don't think you can do too much here quite yet. You might be able to try to bomb down in this room.
Yeah. Oh, man. This manhandle looks to be a little bit beefy based on the first bomb here.
Yeah, I mean... shook off two bombs.
Yeah, looks like he's just going to survive and compass get over... well, somewhere he can't get to, probably.
Yeah, so whatever this purple dungeon is that Antlers is in, and if you think it is 1Q6, that is going to be ladder blocked at this point in time.
Yeah, second quest 6, since we have that level 1 set up, would be the guess still. We know for sure if you clipped across in the land molar room into the river and bombed the north wall, if it's not a walkthrough. I would say we'll just leave them marked for now, wait for them to go back in at some point.
It's definitely a level. We don't know which one it is. Good to come back there, as you said.
For being a two-heart overworld, this is a fairly tame start to the seed. I think that has mostly to do with just not having a ton of Guria overworld screens at this point. I've only seen a couple of mixed Guria overworld screens, and those are the ones that tend to really trip up runners.
Yeah, those Guerias are awful in overworlds.
Alright, so we have that 8-tree spot that people like to wrap into the grave area. Turn into this green dungeon that's on Shroom's side. And it's got a walkthrough, so it's definitely not all. I don't know what I was going to say there, actually. It's going to be. Oh, man. The guesses begin here, man. Second quest 4 is a possibility. Otherwise, it's potential to be shapes.
Yeah, it's hard to say. We really want to get a map or a book to see exactly what we're dealing with. Antlers bombs down the Lionel, grabs a pack of bombs, gonna save his game.
Yep, he's gonna explore the level that he found at Vanilla Star now, I think, since that's the next closest one for him.
Truan finds a heart container in whatever the dungeon is in that he's in. So that's 6 dungeons now.
Yeah, based on the starting screen and not being able to move around at the top yet because of the overworld entries, I think it is going to be second quest 2 that is the green dungeon in the dark woods, or the dead woods, excuse me. What's not nice, though, are these red dark nuts that are in this gray dungeon. They are at or below their normal HP value, so it takes more than one bomb to kill them.
Well, they gotta have roll up, because they have 4 in vanilla. So they have at least 5.
Correct. And, yep, this vertical shoot for me confirms it, because I see that P spot for the standing item into almost always when I'm playing second quest, so that's a good sign that we have it figured out over there.
I didn't see where this level was. Actually, there it goes. It's at the 8th spot in the Deadwoods. Antler is getting bailed out, gets a pack of bombs, and be able to finish off this reverse C. We'll see if this is an item here in whatever dungeon this is.
Oh, that's a big one. Might be a little bit ahead now, but this is really going to open up the seed for him.
Yeah, that's going to give Antlers quite a lead now. Especially with that wand on the coast.
And not going to spend another second in that dungeon, which doesn't surprise me too much. Looks like he's going to go straight for the coast. Well, oh, health, yeah. He's going to go straight for that coast item.
I mean, you can't blame him. You want to get out and get that weaponry as soon as possible. Now, with his ladder and his wand under his belt, and he'll be actually clean a lot of these dungeons pretty quickly. He's going to start moving pretty quick, I would say.
There is no Zelda, only Zol. Well, that's a Fred comment if I've ever seen one from the old man.
Now, this doesn't write true enough anywhere near yet. Boa is still at large. Silver is still at large. We still have a couple dungeons we gotta find, so Truant is definitely still in this. He just has to get down to that dungeon and that level, that vanilla start, and get that ladder.
Yeah, well, man, this is either first. This green dungeon is either a first quest dungeon, like 7, or this is gonna be a fun time for the back half.
You getting the shapes twinge?
Well, you don't know yet, because that start room is potentially level 7's kind of like right below the top row on the bottom side on that second column. But we have chances at a really trolly seed, so I'm hoping.
Well, we got a Pepto-Pink level on the coast for Antlers. This is a nice room, though, because it's right next to where level 9 is. So if he gets that recorder, he'll be able to come right back here if necessary. Oh, and that's not nice to see, though.
Yeah, it's a whiz rude.
Hopefully they have rolled down to 8 HP instead of what they have. You really want to do a 2 bombs, a 4, or, 3. 4 bomb wizards are awful.
Yep.
Gonna take out this Gleok and see if there's a Triforce here or not. Gets him across the ladder, the river as well, since he does have that ladder.
Okay, well, at this point, I think it's a little bit easier to call the back half actually as a first quest setup, because this is, based on the shape he's going through now, it's looking like it's an 8 as this Pepto-Bismol dungeon, which would have put Truant's dungeon earlier. It's at level 7.
Well, if this is in fact 2Q8, there are going to be 2 items here. So this could be another big dungeon. Well, there's actually going to be 3 items here. So it could be another good dungeon for the Antlers to find. And there's a heart, so one of the items is kind of a bust.
Alright, let's see what this staircase has to provide. Oh, wait. Oh, yep. Well. Not looking at a shutter door and then get paid off by the next room actually have a staircase all planned.
Well, that was a transport in that case. Transport comes out in a manhandler. It's always fun. A reverse seaman handler at that.
Yeah. And it's actually blocked, and that is absolutely first quest date, so... Now we know what we're dealing with. I'm sad I didn't get any shapes. But we might have a Wizrobe and Pole's voice room that has an item, so that's fun. I think Antlers knows that this is A2 by the fact that he up-A'd in that right-handed staircase room just a minute ago. Because that would mean that the only way around that would actually be to take the staircase back, because there's only one room and it's to your right.
Now, we see Antlers having a bomb drop in this room. I actually hate to see those, because our White Sword bombs are still in play, so that could be a red herring at this point.
Well, good news. He just cleared up this room and it's dropped a heart container, so he's going to be A-okay. Maybe he doesn't know where he's at just yet.
Yeah, he knows that bomb item is just a level heart, level bomb, I should say. Not going to be the floor item in 8. Looking for one more staircase, though.
But the more he clears, the more that single block room becomes a fun time.
Well, this is potential here. No, shutter door, never mind.
Yeah, it gets every one of us, including me, just a minute ago, so no worries.
The game has to play a couple tricks on us, I guess. Truant gonna find the level up in the vanilla 100 secret.
It'll be interesting to see what the decisions are with regards to First Quest 7, knowing that the front half of your dungeon setup is Second Quest.
With bow and silver still at large and 2 items in there, you kind of have to dig it, I would say.
Now, I'm thinking more in terms of our key scenario that might come into play, because if you played a lot of Second Quest dungeons, you'll notice that the key count that you can pull up is kind of lower than you normally would see in a First Quest setup. So it's one of those where you can kind of hurt yourself with regards to your resources if you decide to opt out of, say, First Quest 7 in a hurry and First Quest 8 without digging too deep. Well, and the Grey Dungeon, gave itself away.
Which one was this?
He had to go past the slide a piece of porter meat block. So it should be Second Quest 3.
Yeah, look at that setup. Yeah, that's gotta be 3, so... And Antler's gonna have to deal with that beefy man handler, get that Triforce here in 8.
Isn't it that staircase, that right-hand staircase room, is a super... Well, somewhat super room, because you have to take it.
Yeah, there's nowhere to hide.
Yeah, that's a bit silly, actually.
He's gonna have one heart, possibly, to deal with this?
Thank you.
I think he still has one item here, though, doesn't he?
I think that's why he cleared that room. He's looking for a key drop and or a staircase room. It looks like Truon's going to opt to go up and through a key door and burn his last key, which is important because it has the Triforce, but now he's got to probably look around a little bit more and see if he can't somehow find an item or two in this dungeon. I didn't see if he got a heart container or anything out of there.
Antlers is in the Triforce room and gives the manhandler a hug. He's going to head away and probably get some HP, maybe come back with a potion to deal with that manhandler room.
I guess he's trying to build a count for maybe a fairy off of these Lynels since he's at max bombs.
Yeah, I'll kill 16 straight and then get a fairy.
So that was a good count building session there. Gonna go back in and try and hold on to as many of these hearts as possible.
The blue line will give him a heart too, so that gave him the 3 from the fairy plus 1 extra.
Looks like you might opt to actually clear this room this time around with the extra hearts in hand.
What you could do is clear off some of the enemies, leave and come back in and see what respawns. Which is what I think he's actually trying.
Long so, Wizrobes.
Well, he got rid of one and the bunny's back, so the bunny could be the dominant enemy.
Come on, Wizrobes.
Well, dealing with 2 is not bad, though. It's weird to deal with 4 or 5. That starts getting a little dicey. Yeah, the bunny's the dominant here.
This game is a disappointment here. Come on. Be a little troll for me.
And it is our second item, and we'll see what we get here. We get the power bracelet.
Mm-hmm. The croissant. It's going to open up. It is mixed quest first or second, so it's going to open up probably more than 4 spots.
8 dungeons, though. So just missing 1.
From my recollection, we are missing just level 5, so I haven't seen anything that looks like the Z shape yet. 4 or 5, I guess, are still technically in play. Everything else is kind of figured out.
See if Antlers has better luck against the Manhandler now that he's a little more souped up. Has 5 hearts, well, 4.5.
Well, what he's going to look to do, I would think, is hit every single one of the claws with a wand beam and then go for the bomb. Because he rolled up, that'll make it a little bit easier to pull off. And yeah, that's what he's going to do.
Very nicely done. That was a beautiful, beautiful kill of a beefy manhandler. And he did exactly what you said he would do. Hit each one twice, damage it a little bit, and then dead center it with the bomb at the end.
Yep, these are things that anybody really can pick up when they start to learn and play the Zelda 1 randomizer. You don't have to necessarily be so good at dodging every last fireball and hitting him twice with a bomb. You can find these little strategies that kind of help you pick up some time that you might lose in your first couple of matches if you take the time to learn these little tactics.
Looks like Antlers might be bowling back up to the level 3 up in Casino Corner here. Gotta check a couple more power burst spots on his way.
Looks like Magical Sword is blocked off by the power bracelet. And the early concerns I have for this is that Truant actually left level 2 with the Triforce, but didn't dig out the item. If he doesn't go back to that dungeon anytime soon, he's not going to have a wand for some time. And while it's not necessarily game over if you don't have the wand within like 5 or 10 minutes of your opponent, the longer you go at a combat disadvantage, the harder it gets to kind of keep pace with your opponent.
Well, wasn't the ladder in the dungeon to the right of Vanilla 1? The Vanilla Start?
Maybe? What was in...
Yeah, because I thought Ladder was in the one at Vanilla Start.
I thought the one at Vanilla Start was 6-ish, and it was Ladder blocked. I could be wrong.
Okay, yeah, so Ladder was in the Dead Woods, that's right. Yeah, you're right, it was in 2.
I can tell you what room layout it was. I can't confirm that it was level 2 anymore, because I'm kind of rethinking everything, but... Hey, we found the item in level 3, and it's the book. So we picked it up right off the bat. Interesting, given he has knowledge of his level setup and knows that they're vanilla shapes. As in vanilla second quest and first quest dungeon designs.
I mean, at worst, at least now we know exactly where we are. And the book is nice. Well, I guess, no, there's no hints, so you won't get much information out of level 9 either. So, yeah, book is kind of obsolete at this point. It's nice for the maps, but not dealing with shapes, it takes away that advantage a little bit.
Yeah, if I were in Antler shoes and I had seen that I had dug level 8, which was the pink dungeon that we saw earlier, and I had dug most of this dungeon out and seen the meat block and probably confirmed in my mind it was second quest 3, I probably would have said no to the item being the book, but sometimes you just want to make absolutely sure, because we saw in one Elite 8 race so far that there was a dungeon that looked a lot like second quest 4, and everybody, commentators, chat, runners, thought it was second quest 4, and then they picked the book up and it was shapes.
So, I believe that Goma in level 3 is going to have their second item.
But yeah, it's potential to happen.
The only other option would be bombs. Because Antlers cleared every other room.
We did have a magic Tutti Flute sighting on Truant's side, by the way. And if we've guessed correctly on our dungeons, that will be in 1. So that's one of the 2 floor items.
I mean, given by that map, that I would say unequivocally that's 1.
So now we're just searching for the second item in level 1, and Triforce, and for Truant's sake, we're hoping it's one of these rooms, like this pancake room, I guess, that you can still technically clear with bombs.
I love when Guerrillas go down to just one one-shot, just because they're such a pain in the overworld.
It looks like Truant retried out of his flute pickup, so he's valuing his resources over his flute, which is a little bit of a harder call for me to make, given that you don't know if there's potential for blocks on the overworld of dungeons and or the White Sword.
Well, Truant is in that white dungeon with the dark knots.
Okay, so this was not the level 6 that I thought it was. So, now we're going to have to sit and wait.
Yeah, I think this is the one I've been able to start. So I think I was actually right on that one. Gonna do a retry to get his money back. His bombs back, I should say.
Yeah, wish I could tell you what dungeon that is, but I have no clue.
Well, he has killed out those dark knots to get into that staircase, I know that much. This right here was the one that is 6-ish. Yes, this one right here is 6, so that's the one next to Burn Row.
Yeah, with Antlers walking in with a book, it makes it really easy to figure out what dungeon that is.
True, unfortunately, does not have that book, and he doesn't have that ladder quite yet. Well, more bombs on the floor. So we got more combat here in this level 6. So there's still a floor item and a staircase item.
Yep. So we have level 2 and level 7 in the Deadwoods. 1 is River Spot. 6 is Candle Row. I would think, based on the lack of bomb walls in the dungeon at Vanilla Start, it's probably more likely to be 5 than it would be 4.
If I was Antlers, I would save this room and come back if I had to.
Oh, but he got Fairy. Hold on.
Okay, he proved me wrong, but still, I probably would have saved that room.
Yeah, that's definitely a room where your nerves get to you a little bit with all the fireballs and blue dark nuts on half a heart.
But combat's not exactly my strong suit, so he's much better than I am.
Well, he does have a nice low percent time, but level 8 is notorious for ending runs too in that setup.
Walk through wall and possible item here. Oh, hello, Red Bubbles. I don't think they do anything to us, though. I think they're just sword removers.
That is lame.
Yeah, they got lucky on the bubble curse.
They got lucky on quite a few things so far on this one.
Well, Antlers did. Truant's having a bit of a run.
Bit of a bomb block, I suppose, in this seed, but having knowledge of where the wand is within the first 5 minutes in a swordless Elite 8 flag set is a dream come true.
antlers running afoul of the blue limb molas, which just were kind of souped up a bit. Antler's making his way back over to the limb mola.
Would I have fought the Red Darknuts in the Grey Dungeon? If it's close to start, I would have farmed up to 8 probably. And it is close to start in this setup, so yeah. I would have. I would have farmed and then gone for it just to see if that was an item. I don't know if I would have made it all the way to the staircase room itself and been able to kill it, but I would have tried to see if that was an item. Speaking of items, we have something else that's very important in this.
Well, that's good for Truan. It gives him a repeatable offense weapon, so that could start his gears a little bit.
Yep. So now, would you, knowing the bow is in your hands, would you ignore this bomb upgrade and aim to go back to the overworld to farm up some money on some medium secrets or the small secrets that are 20 and get wood arrows?
Seeing bunnies in the stun dungeon, absolutely. I don't know if we've seen an arrow shop, though, have we?
Yes, we have. It was Vanilla 1 is, I think, the closest one. Because that's where Antlers picked up his wood arrows really early in the seed.
Antlers versus Lamola's round 2.
This is a random occasion in which having the wand shoot fire off and at the end is actually quite useful.
Yeah, because it can take a little bit of extra damage for the camo burn. I don't mind it too much, especially with Lynels and Gurias and the mummies are in dungeons. Guria. Gibda, sorry. I know my enemies. If you're mindful of the flame, it's really not that big of a deal.
It looks like we have a... Oh, man. Any key. Well, it's still getting pretty rich over on Antler's side as far as good items go. His key problems are gone. He can just burn through every door.
Yeah, the rich get richer, and it's looking for money. Definitely a huge, huge pickup for our antlers. Just able to go through his resources without a care now. Bombs, other than bombs, of course. And 6 HP orange dark nuts. It gets a clock, of course.
Hey, you want to hold your bomb count up in dungeons, but with most of the overworld enemies being 2 HP for a bomb drop, it also is not super important to have your bombs up on exit of a dungeon unless you're planning on going up into a bomb-heavy area of the map, such as Death Mountain.
Well, we're only missing one dungeon still, so, I mean, we might not even have to go up into Death Mountain at all.
And based on their clearing so far, I think we are running out of spots that aren't Death Mountain for it, though. Just a little bit left in the grave, perhaps. Truant went back for that flute that he found earlier and won, so he's now going to test a couple of these overworld spots and see if they might house a level, which would be, I guess, level 4 or 5.
There's our Triforce in level 6. We'll see if he goes for the floor or not, though.
Given how many rooms he's cleared, I would think that that's probably his play for now, but he may also just assume it's the bombs if he doesn't get the next couple rooms.
The only way that would hurt him if it is in fact the silvers.
Yeah, for the most part, yeah. I mean, technically the Wrath could still maybe troll.
Well, there's more bombs.
And now I'd have to see his map to really know.
Yeah, looks like he's just gonna grab that Triforce and leave now.
It's not. I wouldn't necessarily mark that it's bombs in this dungeon, but I would be mindful of the fact that it could have been.
Kinda just mark it as a asterisk at this point.
Yeah, I'd make a mental note not to go back there unless I'm stuck.
Antler's gonna go finish level 1 now, where he'll get his flute. Having that book is nice, because now we can know exactly where we are without any kind of play of the game. And there's the very quick flute.
I wonder if Truant's actually tried to burn the Lynels, or if that was just what we saw from Antler's feed.
Well, we have another room here that Truant couldn't kill earlier, so we'll see if this is our second item in level 1 or not.
You know, that is a really rude screen that Truant tried to flute to there.
Well, the second item level 1 is just a heart container, so we got both. So level 1 was the flute and a heart.
It looks like it technically was not that hard to get to both items.
Yeah, just resource blocked, you needed keys. And a force to Dango kill.
And a Triforce, all blood ladder, wow.
So, think of what we have for items. We don't know about the MN5 and the both items in level 4 are quite yet. Or level 7, I believe.
Yep, we need one item out of 7 because the bow was there. We need 3 out of 4. And we need 1 out of 5 and 2 out of 2 if the ladder was in 5. This is presuming that the question mark dungeon is 5, which we haven't fully confirmed.
So we're missing either level 4 or 5 at the moment. And I was gonna go back in level 2 and I was gonna find level 2.
Yeah, he's been here once. He just didn't have. He didn't go down this side at all.
Well, he just burned it open, so what did he do? Retry afterwards?
Did he just burn it open?
Yeah, I think this is his first trip in here, because he just burned that bush.
Interesting. I thought he was the one that saw this earlier.
And you're able to despawn the orange dart wizards too, which stinks. Well, good for them, bad for us.
Hey, Truon has money now. And look where he's going, not wasting a second. Going straight to yet another arrow shop that was right next to the one we saw. I saw before.
I like that pickup, especially when you have 58 minutes and you finally get repeatable offense. Now, he does have to be careful that he has money, though. He has to kind of keep his money count up.
Yep. He still hasn't really taken on those Lynels on that screen, so I guess he probably doesn't know if they're 2 health.
And there's our silvers in level 2 on the ground.
So barring a raft block of the last outstanding dungeon, we have go mode achieved.
I don't remember where the Triforce in level 2 was. I know Truant got earlier, so it has to be in the northern part of the dungeon.
It's on the left side if he's the one that was in here earlier.
Bombs left, and if as long as it goes down his leg, if that's where the Triforce is, he'll be able to pick that up.
Alright, so Antlers picks up his item in level 2 here, I think, because this was the room I remember it being in. So this is a heart container.
So I mean, he doesn't need it, but he might as well pick it up.
Yeah, well, I mean, it gives him a chance at magical bombs if he ever has to route that way again. He needs a bomb pack. So why not?
Sorry, be careful with these dark wizards though.
Yeah, that was a unfortunate setup there with traps, Wizrobes. Wizrobe being the dominant enemy in this room is never a fun time. You're almost going to have to walk into... Well, yeah, you're going to have to walk in the line of fire, basically, to take him on, and that's kind of a game over every time.
Yeah, one thing we didn't mention is we did have a 2-heart start, so even on your up and A's, you will only start with 2 hearts. He is right next to the fairy fountain, though, so if he hits it too many times, you may go get a quick heal and then come back. Or you can just get it right there.
Now, we knew it had to be somewhere pretty easy to get to because Truon only had candle and bombs when he was in here earlier and was able to pick up the Triforce, so it's not surprising that it was sitting there on the ground.
Alright, so let's Antler's gonna check our grave and we'll see if we can find our hidden dungeon over here. All right, so Antlers going through the grave. Flute did not trigger there. A couple more push spots. So still nothing here. Hunt for the mysterious dungeon, either level 4 or level 5, depending on what is that vanilla star is still at large. Large creature blocked by the power bird, so gonna lose some money, but at this point in the scene, I don't think he cares.
No, that just means that's mixed first. And he already has a lot of money saved up, so nothing much more he'd have to buy. I don't think he's one of those people that buys the blue ring.
Well, he bought meat just in case he needs it, but I don't think he will, considering it's a first quest level 7.
And we saw a meat block of a key door, but it was in an area where you can still access that room above it, potentially from the right or from the top, so I don't know that it's really going to mean anything.
But I mean, at this point, he doesn't need keys. The only other thing he could really want is bombs, which aren't that expensive, so you might as well use it, because you're going to lose it if you don't.
Yep, I suspect the only other thing he'll go for is bomb upgrade.
Yeah, it was only 79, so that's definitely worthwhile. And he'll see one when he goes through 4, so...
Yep, one will definitely be in 4, and the other one will be in 7 or 8.
I'm a little surprised you didn't pick up the letter right there to get some potions.
To each their own, I suppose. Actually, I think we saw the other bomb upgrade in 7, didn't we? I remember Churon burning something.
So what's your take on the letter? Do you pick it up or do you leave it behind?
Depends on whether or not I have Red Ring.
Well, at this point, he's still on Green Tunic, so...
Yep, but for my strategy, if I have Red Ring, it sits there and never gets picked up. If I have anything else, I decide against having to avoid it on the scroll over with my select button. And pick it up.
Truant into level 3, so he'll get his book and probably not be too happy with it. At least he'll tell him what dungeons he's in. There's a lovely white sword item, your favorite item.
Yeah, he'll regret not picking it up.
I doubt it, but we'll see.
Did you see the race last night?
I did not.
Well, I won't tell you who won, because that'd be rude, but... There was definitely some times where the runners probably regret not being able to stun their enemies in one place. Get them all with, like, bombs or take care of them. Because they didn't have the wand. In Antler's case, maybe it's not as important. But it could still help you if the Dig Dogger split off into 3 and whatever dungeon's left outstanding for him.
I will always pick up a boomerang, depending on where I am in the seed, but I won't pick up the second one. I just pick up whatever one I find first.
Yep. And just to prove my point, the boomerang that we had available last night during that race was Lord Banana, and I was still for picking that up because it was still going to go ahead and stun things up.
Well, Truant just found something nice in level 3. He found our red candle. So that's actually going to give him a better offensive weapon than using his money.
Was that a block by a boss, like a Goma?
That was blocked by the Goma that I was we were talking about.
Nice. So need the bow out of 7 to get the red candle as your potential other repeatable damage source.
Correct.
And we found level 4, so now we know the dungeon at Vanilla Starts level 5 on top of that.
Yes, so 5 had our letter. 4 is going to have 2 items for us, but we might just grab the Triforce and run at this point in the scene.
Hard to say. I think you still definitely check the staircase for the Red Ring. It's still relatively useful, knowing that Wizrobes will be in level 9.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I'm just saying, if you come across the Triforce first, you're not going to stay extra time.
Oh, but like, he'll clear this room, for example, and see if this has a red ring or something useful.
Well, it's going to have a item, and it's going to have the red ring.
Yeah. See, you just can't pass staircases up on free rooms like that.
Well, he's also looking for the bow still as well.
True, so he's definitely not going to pass it up. In fact, that actually will almost compel him to dig this entire floor just to see if he can find it.
So Aquaman is just holding a key for us. I love when you have the any key and the mugger guy wants bombs, because keys, I should say. They're just like, whatever, here you go.
Land moles guarding a staircase, huh?
Second item, and we have another heart container. Nice to find both items relatively quick, though.
Well, 2 of the 3, at least.
Ah, yeah, 1 floor item, too.
He may be less likely to clear every single room looking for the floor drop if he finds the Triforce soonish.
And our Triforce is not blocked by those Dark Nuts. Gonna have to kill a few more rooms. True, I'm about to find level 4, though.
Yeah, he'll be pretty happy with what he finds in here, because I would think that he'll easily clear that room with all the gels in it and get the red ring with the red candle in his hands.
Yeah, he'll definitely be happy to see that red ring. And we've got a bomb upgrade, and it's only 2 bombs. So a bomb upgrade, not that great.
Yep, but I definitely say that you can't blame Antlers for wanting it. 250 rupees, go for it.
Oh, absolutely, always. And I believe this is our red ring for... No, never mind.
Now you go through this staircase and through a door or two. I don't know that he has enough keys, actually, to get there. Oh, yes, he does. It's down from this room.
This room right here.
Yep, whole bunch of chocolate chips that you get to burn up and get a red ring out of. Seems good.
I'll take that trade.
Yeah, Yeah, he definitely doesn't need 250 rupees worth of arrows. It'll be interesting to see if he turns down the second cheap bomb upgrade later. My guess would be he probably will, but...
I would probably take it, because what else does he have to buy? Can't take it with you.
It depends on how much money he farms up by that point. If he's only got, you know, maybe he has to buy a pack of bombs or something, let's say, and he goes down to, like, mid-150 range... Do you really want to burn down to like 70 rupees and then have 70 rupees worth of arrows to clear through 9 faster? That's kind of the question I would have to ask.
Without wand, I would say no. With the wand, I would say yes, because you can't use arrows on wizards anyway.
No, but you know that the dark nuts aren't part of their setup. You know that fires are potentially in play with them and gibdos, so it's... You have at least some things that you can clear faster in there.
Yeah, I mean, I guess I just see as you have extra wizard ammunition, personally. All depends on playstyle, I guess.
It actually somewhat depends on what setup these Dig Doggers are in. Or not Dig Doggers, Dodongos.
Yeah, there's in a little bit of trouble, though. He's out of bombs.
In a room with Gibdo, you'd think they'd drop one. No. Well, at least he knows where the compass will lead him to, and that's towards the center of the dungeon, so... Once he gets bombs or a couple walkthrough walls, he'll be able to progress towards the Triforce.
Now, does he go for the floor item, or does he head on? That's the question at this point. I think I would head on, personally. Because you can always come back, you have the flute.
Yeah, this is an interesting predicament for both runners. One has to definitively dig level 7. I think it's likely he'll actually find the staircase, because it was kind of a linear route. While the other runner also has to clear a rather linear route through a staircase to find another staircase for the ladder. So both runners are going to have to go through a somewhat linear path in a dungeon of their... choosing to get to the items they need to start really motoring. Oh hey, there's the raft, so now it's just whatever. We now know every item it's for, it's not the bow.
And our Triforce level 4 is in Dig Dagger blocked, but we have the flute already, so no big deal there. Locked in a room with a Dig Dagger, of course.
Yep, and they motor fast, so... Got all three. Thankfully, he had the red ring, because you don't want to walk through all in the event that it's randomly one of those one-way walkthroughs. So here comes the play, back into 5 for Antlers, it looks like. So he'll leave 7 to last. Meanwhile, Truant is buying some keys, because he's out.
So he's just looking for his Triforce here, most likely. Well, he needs the bow, so maybe he'll dig out a few more rooms.
Yeah, he's gonna have to make a decision to dig something at some point here for his bow. Whether that be level 9, which is probably the least friendly of the dungeons to dig, because it's the largest left.
He may just clear out the easy ones on his path to the Triforce. Then kind of see what he has left to do.
Yep, I suppose it really depends on how long a path it is to that Triforce. Because if you get a staircase that shortcuts you right to that room, you have a lot of rooms left, you may opt to come back. Whereas if you have to take some convoluted path that takes you through all but three or four rooms, it may compel you a little bit more to search.
Yeah, the decision to clear that room in this level 5 on Antlers' first pass here to get that ladder was definitely a huge play in this race.
Yeah, unfortunately, though, gets shuttered in with some danger noodles, and that's going to send him back to the Dark Knight room again.
Yeah, I got to clear it again. And 6 HP Dark Knights is not fun. Just slow to kill.
Looks like he might be setting up some sort of count or hoping for some hard drop here.
Well, he took a hit, so he's not going to be able to get that 16 count.
I find it a little bit interesting that he's going to maybe choose to go back up into the Slamola room. So he can only have the floor drop, really.
He did what I was hoping he would do. He clips into the block. That little Molas can't do anything to him.
Question of whether or not it'll pay off, though. Yeah, it's just a key. I don't know on that one.
I mean, trying to be thorough. Watch his bow.
Was the ladder in this next reverse C with these red darkness, too?
Yeah, the ladder was in this room here.
Man, that... I should have been paying attention. That was actually quite an accomplishment for him to do that early. That is not a free setup.
Yeah, he got 2 bomb drops in that room with the Dark Knights. That's kind of what bailed him out. Not bailed him out, but it let him complete it. Man, more Dark Knights.
Yep.
Just a big old Dark Knight party here in 5.
Yeah, it looks like he is going to opt to look for the 4 item, though. He's going to clear this way.
Didn't have many rooms left, so I like the play. A lot of orange dark knights, not too many blue ones.
Hey, maybe in hindsight, with all this nonsense going on, a potion would have been a decent enough play.
I don't know, myself, with my lack of combat skills, I will always get a potion if need be. Especially in Flags of this where you have the red bubbles. It gets a clock. And a heart. See what our Triforce in level 5 is being guarded by. And more Linmola. But... easy makes quick work of him, grabs a Triforce in 5. Now he has to walk over to level 7, and he will be good to go to 9. Gotta get that bow, though, at level 7.
Yep, yeah, he's gonna have to dig this.
With as thorough as he's been, I think for sure he'll dig this out.
Well, you can't really make a logical play to dig level 9 before digging level 7. Especially with this being first quest. Second quest has a lot of staircases, and it's a bit more annoying for digging staircase items at least.
Yeah, I want to say the bow wasn't too deep into level 7, so he should get it pretty quickly. Truant unfortunately out of keys again. The any key paying off future antlers. GVSU Laker, yes, this is best of three. I want to say our bow might be right here behind this manhandler. And with Red Ring, you're just going to tank his face.
I'm not sure if Truant went across the top row here. Pretty sure he went kind of across the middle.
Yeah, it looks like Anna's just kind of clearing it how I like to clear my levels. Just go by row, so that way you don't miss a room. Kind of like a sweeping motion, almost.
And this key door that was in this room that he just bombed out of would confirm that the meat block was not necessary to actually get anywhere. He's just going to be able to walk right through him once he goes down.
Walks right through the hungry moblin and goes downward. Well, there is our Triforce, our compass, I should say. So the Triforce is buried pretty deep. Looks like he is going to be looking for that, though, which I like. We know it's not here because Truant was not able to kill this room.
Yeah, I want to say it was to the right or up from here. This room is just, well, no, maybe. I don't think that he cleared a manhandle, did he?
I don't think so, but I could be wrong. Yeah, I was wrong. Or nope, that's just a bar of the transport.
Oh, that's a that staircase, though.
That's a A-plus transport. Well, we got some fire. These guys are easy to deal with. And here is going to be our bow.
Yeah, fires make sense. You bomb the fires, you get that recruit off in hurry.
So at 126, Antlers is now in go mode 100%. And Truant about to get up his Triforce in level 4. Gonna pass it for now.
Yep, he's desperate for a ladder.
Yeah, both items are in the lower part of the dungeon.
Well, he's going to get his raft when he goes upper room here, I think. He's really low on money again, too, so he's running out of arrows.
Truant grabs Triforce and 4, gets his 3rd on the day. Antlers about to grab his 8th. So Antlers will be heading to level 9. Fury, what's he going to be doing here in level 9?
Well, he's not going to be looking for old men because they're going to be useless to him. He's instead going to be looking for a shutter door that doesn't open when he clears the room, or a shutter door that opens before he clears the room if he's actually found and defeated the pig. And he'll be listening for the roar again in an adjacent room so that he can find him and defeat him with 8 or less wand hits and a silver arrow.
Alien's going to try to farm some bombs off these Lynels first, which I can't disagree with. You want to go in with a full set if you can. Because the Wizards will 100% be here somewhere.
Yeah, it looks like Truant, unfortunately, is heading towards level 8 again, so he's basically written off that staircase in level 5 as having much.
Yeah, just a case of not wanting to deal with the combat, unfortunately. Gonna have to bomb some overly powered wizards though to get through anywhere in this level 9.
Now the good news is they will still drop bombs, so you can kind of keep your bomb count together if you can keep yourself out of the line of some of these fireballs.
There's really no item left that could help him anymore, so he's probably not going to bother looking for anything.
Well, looks like we replaced Zelda with a Patra.
So when you're just looking for Ganon and Zelda, do you still take staircases?
Depends on door scenario. Like right now, where he has to bomb up. Unless this is a roar that he heard or something, I would have taken the staircase just to conserve resources for as long as possible.
Yeah, this looks like a bomb-heavy level 9 so far.
Because now he's down to 6 bombs, because he just had to bomb all 3 of those walls, plus the wall to get into that room. He's going to need at least 2 bombs to take down a Wizrobe. And if there are Vires, which it's looking less and less likely, it actually looks like it's Pulse Voice, Wizrobes, Stalfos, and Super Ropes.
Well, gonna have to play with these Lynels outside for a bit longer. Every time he leaves, he's gonna respawn the dungeon, though.
Yeah, I think you just gotta start taking some staircases and see if you can't open up new areas.
And again, chat, if you guys have enjoyed this race, please give both these guys a follow for a heck of a race, as well as our tracker behind the scenes, Belmort79, and of course my co-com today, FurySK. It's always a pleasure to call with you, my friend.
Yep, and we see, hey, look, we have 2 staircases. Guess where they go?
Always, right next door to each other.
At least close enough. The only 2 that I saw on the screen so far, right next and connected.
Gotta love when Ganon likes to do that with his staircases, put them side by side.
Looks like he loved it so much the first time, he's going to do it again.
And I was kind of like looking at his map like, really? That red ring helped me out a little bit with this combat in level 9.
Was it a shutter door in the top right room that he was able to explore? I don't remember.
I'm not sure, but he's not looking like he has a lot of places he can go at the moment. Gets a full 10 bombs, though. Now, again, we had a two-heart start, so every time you up an A's, he's going to come back to life with just two. And if he has to go up this way, that's going to eat up anywhere between four and five hearts just because those wizards rolled up a bit.
Yeah, this is a potential staircase room. Even though it's first quest level 9, they can move out of the second quest dungeon, so he's got to clear it.
You can kind of use the door to bait them into lining up for you. And it is a staircase, and we're going to go through it. It is a transport, and we'll see where it kicks us out. Alright, so we got to a new part of the dungeon. Goes right into a Wizard of Crossfire. And we are getting instinct that he has heard Ganon in this room. And the light goes out, and here is Ganon. And a shutter door on the opposite side, so that could be Zelda.
No, we don't want it to be that easy. Don't say that.
Ganon goes down. Very nice stun lock. We'll see if Zelda's right next door or not. And she is not, so the hunt is still on.
Now, if the shutter door had opened, say, in a shoot room there on the other side, I would have been okay with that, but...
Well, yeah, because you're evil.
Look, this seed has been, outside of the ladder being kind of significantly hard to get to, pretty simple. So I got a roof or something.
Yeah, all in all, it wasn't that bad of a seed. It was just a right order type of seed. And wanting to deal with some Dark Knight combat.
Man, this patch is going to block off some of his route that he can take, although I think this may just line up to the chute again.
Yep, we got back-to-back patches. Truant grabbing his power bracelet in level 8. And I was able to bomb to the right, and just another key door. Get some bombs from the Stalfos.
That can be a staircase room, and that can be a staircase room, and this is not going to look good here. Yep, goodbye. He does have bombs again, though.
Gonna go shoot some more Lynels. Get some more bombs.
Yep, that's a good screen to have right outside the dungeon.
Especially because they're squishy. If they were all that squishy, that I wouldn't consider that great, but to have them die to one arrow is nice.
I really want to see what's kind of like up in this corner again, because I don't recall what that door was. I wanted to say it was a shutter that was blocked by some other hodgepodge setup somewhere in the double block room that he keeps going through.
Alright, so on Truant's side, he is back in level 5. So he is going to deal these Dark Nuts. And then see that reverse seed with more Dark Nuts.
Yeah, it's worth noting that he does have the bomb upgrade now. So it's... even at just plus 2, it will help him some. The downside is, well, now I got a bomb pack, so I was gonna say the downside is he hasn't gotten nearly as lucky with his bomb drops.
I think there was another six in this room. And there's Gibbos right next door too.
Yeah, you gotta hope he goes left first as opposed to up. Up's gonna be a bad day. Although I think it does have a key drop in it that he would desperately need.
Alright, so this room right here is the one that Truant has to beat to get his ladder and his wand.
Yeah, he's gonna nope out of that room and have instant regret, I suspect.
He's gonna try to clip it to the block, so it's not gonna be as punishing.
Yeah.
Nice play by him to not take a death in this room. Very well done, Betcher. Gonna get a heart back. And now I kind of think he understands what he has to do.
Yeah, it's... There's only, like, one bomb wall, I think, that goes from side to side in all level 5. So it's gonna save him from missing this room, unless he just tries to get away from it at any cost.
Yeah, he's going to avoid that for now. Hopefully he doesn't use too many bombs. Gonna see the Triforce on the right hand side here. Not picking it up, which I like.
I mean, the consolation prize here is he doesn't really have a lot of time left to catch up, so it won't be a play that really hurts him. But, man, if this were to have gone on for like another 25, 30 minutes and he kept skipping that room, he really would have kicked himself, I think.
Yeah, definitely agree. Antler's getting a little bit of a runaround level 9, though, not playing friendly with him.
It certainly might take him a little while still, but I think the writing still might be on the wall in terms of him being able to finish this seed off within a reasonable amount of time.
Yeah, I agree with you. I'd say it's it takes something pretty bad to happen to Antlers at this point.
Yeah, especially when you get a clock in this room.
That shutter door just got me pretty bad. I thought that was it. That shutter was not it, however.
You know, I'm going to kind of go out on a limb here soonish and say that that southeast corner still looks rather suspect. Because I don't think it lets you to the left right off the bat. It forced you up, and then you couldn't get directly down into the room next to that starting area.
Yeah, true. Heading back to the reverse C, so he's going to grab his ladder. As long as you can take out this room with 9 bombs.
I think he'll definitely have the bombs to do it. The health is going to be a small concern, though. One heart just means he can only take a little bit of damage here.
He does have Red Ring, so it's not going to be a one-hit kill.
Oh, please don't troll him. No. No, game. That's so rude.
So oh, there's Gibdos right next door.
No. Gibdos.
Well, he's one room shy, so he's going to save and go back in. But now he has to kill the original five again.
Yep. We're going to see there's only a couple rooms left up here for Antlers to kind of explore, and they don't seem to be paying off. So it's either northwest corner, maybe staircase block, or southeast unless it's through the ski door. And it does not, so now he's got two options. So we did not hear any sounds of shutters or opening when he entered that room. Pretty sure it's panic mode now for Antlers, though. He's been around this nine for a while, and we are getting closer and closer to that 2 hour mark.
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't know how far ahead he is, but it's that kind of gut feeling like, shoot, I'm playing with Truant Gamer, who is absolutely no slouch. Truant is a very, very good player at this game. So I could be an Antlers head a little bit, that Zelda's kind of messing with him a bit.
I feel like she's, like, right next door to where he's at now.
And one of those two teeth there?
Maybe just the room below the staircase he's gonna take. Because I don't think you can take that room from the starting room. If you're looking for my meta advice of level 9s to go quickly, it's if there's a random path that it forces you in level 9 that doesn't seem very conventional, you're better off trying to figure out why it wouldn't let you go that direction.
Yeah, definitely a heads-up play as far as that goes. It's blocked for a reason, usually.
I would try and get down there as soon as possible and see what exactly is up with that situation.
Alright, so Truant gets through the first leg of this loveliness of Darknuts. Gonna get a 10 count going if he can.
Looks like Antlers is gonna try and get in there. And gets noped on one wall, gets noped on the second wall. Oh,
magic
man,
staircase.
It's well, I don't know that it is because he hasn't bombed a lot of these walls, but man, it's awful suspect to me.
Well, he can go down here. That's gonna get him down again. Alright, so now he was down to the teeth.
May have just been a trap or a bait. And it is a bait, because there is no sound there, so... May want to clear this room for a staircase to go northwest.
Yeah, because it's looking like it might be up in the upper west side now.
And I know he's bombed almost all of those walls, so... This is going to be hide-and-seek champion mode for Zelda, for sure.
Turn to be just a bit short in bombs again. I'm having flashbacks of the Dr. J unit. Oh, you got it!
Oh, we
gets on the last bomb.
He boomerangs it because he knows this has to be some sort of item, and yeah. At this point, if I'm truant, I'm just like, well, this is absolute ball game for me. I have no chance anymore.
Yeah, when you're 2 hours in and you do, I wouldn't say that's by any means a free wand, a free ladder, I should say. But that was obtainable very quickly, as you saw Antlers get it pretty early.
Yeah, you're not expecting your opponent necessarily to be able to pull that off 10 minutes in, but you would assume by like the hour and a half mark your opponent has the bomb upgrade and was suspect of that verse C if you cleared that first room. And the first room is really the only downside of Truant's play so far, that he didn't want to go back so close to a level that's a level that is close enough to where he started the seed.
Now, let's travel back in time about hour and a half or so. Remember when I said that, and it's never fun to have 4 HP, 4 bombs worth of blue wizard. Guess what we have?
Exclamation point memory. I don't remember a thing.
We have four bombs worth of blue wizard, unfortunately, and Antlers bombed one 3 times and did not fall. So our blue wizards have probably 13 or 14 HP.
So are you rooting for a 8 blue wizard room with a staircase to get to Zelda? Is that what you're rooting for?
I figured that's what you would be rooting for, considering how you do not like these runners.
Press up A now. That's a nice strategy. So he's going to go back down this rope room, presumably, and try and clear it again. And see if this staircase is, in fact, a staircase.
See if it brings him to the upper western part of the map. I mean, at this point, there's just some bombs.
Well, it was out, so maybe there'll be a staircase in the next room. Or another old man. What if Zelda was
not being helpful?
Interesting strategies and questions being posed, but not much advice.
Trent about to grab his Triforce out of 5, picks it up, and now he's still alive. I mean, it's not over yet. Level 9 being level 9.
That's true, but at the same time, how likely is it that he can find a path to Zelda quicker than Antlers did here, potentially?
Well, I mean, like I said, it's gotta take a miracle, but here's the wizard that he could not form on.
Please be the banana.
And down goes the wizard, and we have a staircase.
Oh, burn the witch on that one.
And, chat, I think you guys know what to do to Fury here. I think Antlers is in a new part of the map, though. I don't think he's been up here quite yet. There's a transport here. We'll see where this one takes us. Okay, so we're in the southern part of the map, on the upper western part.
Uh-oh, this looks promising.
We can bomb to the left, and still no shutter.
Well, got one more room up here.
And there it is. The shutter door opens up. Antler goes through it. And he is going to take game one of this best of three.
Well, he hoists the Triforce in level 9 as Truant gets his fifth Triforce out of level 1. So he started making some ground up in a hurry here at the end. Just not enough time once he found the wand to make it back.
We'll see if Antlers wants to come out and chat with us.
Yep, it's not over yet between these two runners, though. I believe they have another game set up for a couple days from now for their game 2 matchup, because this is a best of 3.
And as we said at the beginning, the winner of this gets to play you.
Now, that Super Mario 3 recorder, what is that from? Like, that can't be the theme.
It's part of the whistle too, when you play the whistle.
Wait for him. I'm going to go investigate what that sound is.
Alright. Truant does grab his any key here in level 6, so he gets all the keys. And now he just has to go grab that Triforce.
Yeah, I suspect he probably is starting to realize how this seed kind of got out of hand once you got the ladder, because the ladder leads you right to a wand and leads you to an any key. And he gets to turn and burn through all this because he has everything else.
Well, he needs silvers in 2. He has to go back to level 2 to get the silvers.
I suppose that's true.
And with that, we do have Antlers in chat with us. GG Antlers, well played, my friend. Or Antlers.
Hey.
There he is.
Sorry about that.
GG,
guys.
My friend, well played.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
So, talk to that level 9, that was fun. If you're talking, we can't hear you at the moment.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Okay, gotcha. So, did you hear anything I said?
No.
Okay. So, that level 9 was awful. I never want to see it again. I was feeling really good going in, but about 25 minutes into it, I was like, well, I'm going to see a dot done any second here. I felt like I probably had a lead going in just because when I found the wand, I figured if I didn't get it first, I didn't get it too far behind him. But yeah, that level 9 was just awful. It was awful, and I didn't play it well either. Like, I took a bunch of bad deaths. I didn't conserve my bombs well. I just did not play it like I should have.
So about when you killed Ganon, Truant picked up his ladder.
Oh no.
Yeah, the first trip into level 5, he saw the Dark Knight room and did not want to deal with it. And he was just getting back there when you killed Ganon.
Yikes. That sucks. The seed. Man, I don't even want to think about the seed without some sort of offense pretty early. The bow was in level 7, but I just pulled up the restream and I see that he's in level 7 right now. I don't know if he got that early.
He did, and to make it more fun, our red candle was the second item in level 3 behind the Goma, so you need the bow in 7 to get to the red candle in 3.
Yeah, I knew it was either the one in level 3 that I knew I didn't need because I was in go mode, or the second item in level 9. Either one would be just awful to get. I mean, level 3 wouldn't be that bad, but yeah. It looks like, oh man, he hasn't found the silvers yet either, has he?
No, he has not gone back to level 2 to get those off the floor.
Yeah, that was... at that point, I wasn't leaving anything behind, except for the floor item in 7. If I did not find the bow in that staircase in 7, I was going back to level 3, then I was going to 9, then the last ditch would be digging the floor item in 7. I absolutely despise doing that, but...
I think you only found one item in level 9?
Yeah, I found the, I found the banana in level 9, and I found the, I also found the white sword when I was looking for the last, or the white sword item when I was looking for the last level, magical boomerang. I don't know if he's found that yet.
He did. He does have the, wooden arrows, so he can, He's gonna look for the floor item here on level 7. No, gets a Triforce though.
Well, hopefully that'll encourage him to leave level 7 without the floor item. Okay, good. It looks like he's leaving. This would have been way nastier too if there weren't a group of blue Lionels right outside of level 9. That made it a lot, well, a little more bearable. I don't want to say a lot. That was still awful.
So when you saw those Dark Knights and you got through on your first attempt, had you not, would you have been going back there? Would you have been moving on? I'm curious.
If what had happened?
So what happened to him was he ran out of bombs. If you had run out of bombs within that reverse, would you have tried going back, or would you have come back later?
I probably would have. So, where I almost ran out of bombs was in the reverse C. I probably honestly would have just retried, because I had just saved with max bombs and done it again, and built up a count first, knowing that I was gonna have to do that, because Red Dark Nuts are bomb droppers anyway, and they're pretty easy to force off of, so if I get my count to like 3 before the first room, take care of that one, then it's at 8 when I go into reverse C. I think there were 5 Dark Nuts in that first push block. It would have made reverse C pretty free. I just didn't know what was on the other side of that staircase when I first went there, so I feel like I probably would have, but you can never say for sure, honestly, until you're in that situation. You know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. So what happened with him was he cleared down to one dark on the left and was one bomb short.
No. In the reverse C or in the first push block room?
In the, the first time he missed the reverse C. He left after the first dark knight room. The second time he got to the reverse scene was one bomb short.
Yeah, that almost happened to me. Like, I had to have a bomb drop off that global, or I wouldn't have been able to clear it. So, like I said, I feel like I probably would have gone in, or gone back in. Oh, this level 8 also sucked, by the way. I had completely forgotten about level 8, because it was like the first dungeon that I full cleared. And, it was awful. I hated it. A beefy, you get 2 hearts to start, and then you have to go in and take out a beefy Manhandla to get the Triforce. And you gotta dodge a bunch of Gleeoks too.
Yep, Truant has waved the white flag. Looks like he was not going back to two anytime soon, as he was saying in IRC, so he's, he'll be joining us shortly.
Alright, let's get some GGs in chat for Truant, please. Hacker Race by both runners, please give them both a follow, as well as our tracker behind the scenes, Belmort 79.
I mean, the real winner of this race is the one that didn't have to even look at level 9, probably.
Yeah, that level 9 was ass.
It was better than last night, but it was not good.
Yeah, I mean, two nights in a row, there have been just awful, awful level 9s. That one, it forces you to take a staircase just to get out of the right side of the dungeon. Then it has a magic staircase to get to Zelda. Only one staircase leads over there. It wasn't like there were multiple paths. And it was a big area too. So you go up and you go through and bomb drop or bomb walls all the way along the western side, and you just couldn't find the path, and that it just chewed through your bombs. And it was a really, really disconnected 9 too, just regardless of that. Like, it seemed like there were so few bomb walls and so few doors that you could actually traverse.
Well, when you have blue darkness, blue wizard up there, you need 4 bombs to kill, plus orange ones, you need 3 bombs to kill. It's just not fun. And we do have Truant with us. GG, Truant. Good attempt. Tough seed.
Yeah, I would have been better off if I didn't avoid 5 as much as I did.
Yeah, that was kind of the turning point in the seed. Antlers had that quite a bit earlier, and that's kind of let him take the race.
And by quite a bit earlier, he means it's the first dungeon item that I found. So, I mean, I can't imagine not having that for, like... He said that you got it as I was killing Ganon, so I can't even imagine that would have made the seed so rough. But yeah, I mean, it could have easily been crap, and meanwhile you would have been, you know, finding something good. So it was just the luck of the draw on that one.
Yeah, I just didn't want to deal with those rolled up red dark notes at the time. I just I had other dungeons. There was, 5 dungeons right there on the southwest that were mostly available, so I wanted to dig everything else before I forced my hand.
Yeah, I can imagine. I had to get really lucky in that reverse C. On my last bomb, I had 2 left, and I had to get a global to take the last one out. And I
missed mine. He turned at the very last second with my last bomb and faced me, and I gave him a couple arrows to the face in retaliation.
Yeah, the reds are even worse than the blues in that regard. They'll just like 180 on you. And it you know, there's no rhyme or reason a lot of the time. You'll think you've got them, and they'll just, nope, I'll just look right at that bomb.
Alright, so that wraps up game 1. You guys have game 2 in mind already?
I think we were looking at, 11:30 on Thursday?
Yeah, 11 or 11:30, either or.
Okay, yeah, it doesn't matter to me. Just whatever works better for you. I'm completely free, so let me know and we can do that. But if it makes you feel any better... I literally full cleared 9 every single room, and I had to leave to farm bombs I think literally 7 or 8 times.
I think you had one segment left. I think it was another magic staircase to the southwest on the farthest left column, and I think that was the end of the road as far as what was.
I saw those rooms. Those were, I got through there with a bomb, and I was like, oh, cool, progress. And then I went north, and I got another dead end. But I did see the southwest. The only one I wasn't sure of, honestly, the right eye, I wasn't sure if I saw it. But every other room, I was positive, because I, like, as I was walking into the last room, I was like, I was just saying, this has to be it. This absolutely has to be it. And it ended up being it. But I'm pretty sure I found every single room. I could be wrong, but I think I did.
Yeah, you might have seen the key door to it or something and left it alone. But when you looked at your map at the start screen for the last time, that was the last. You had a big segment up in the northwest and just a, like, literally one or two rooms left in the bottom. Like, not the tooth of the skull, but, like, the left side.
Oh, no, I understood what you're saying. I'll have to go back and look at the VOD. I was almost, I mean, I was, like, 99% I looked at those, but, either way, it doesn't really matter. It was nasty enough regard.
All right, so Gigi, both of you, we will look forward to seeing you guys go again on Thursday. Until then, I was Dark Falls, but today was Fury SK, Track and Force was Belmore 79. Everyone have a great evening. We'll see you guys on the next race.
Yeah, thanks for the comments and the restream, guys.
Yep, shouts to Captain Green 7 as well for the restream there, picking it up for us.
And the tracking. Don't want to forget the tracking.